Small changes at home can keep me healthy and happy, and I want to do them. I am a clinical psychologist helping people with anxiety, trauma, depression, and happiness, of course, for the past 27 years in Mexico and in California. And I'm very happy to be here with you here today with my husband. So let's dive into
living in harmony is possible if you know your emotions and how to handle them. I am Dr. Carmen Roman, and I will share with you the current psychology by myself or by interviewing experts who will inspire you. Learn how to live a life of fullness and how to recover your emotional harmony. Welcome to Emotions in Harmony.
Welcome back to this Emotions in Harmony podcast. Thank you for being with us, even though we were not there for you the last 3 weeks or four. We have an explanation. I hope you take it. The reason is I really try hard for every 3 months or 4 months to not to publish that much so I can rest and my team can rest as well. And we are more fresh, we have better quality for you, and everybody is happier. Yeah. So this is the reason. I try to rest me, myself, and my team. And that occurs normally in August, in December, and sometimes March, if we don't have coronavirus years. Yeah. So we haven't been able to rest for this year. So that's it. Okay. The last 4 weeks has been, well, full of experiences. Yeah. How are you, my dear?
I'm very good. I survived the 4 weeks.
You survived, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's right. It was the week of the vacation. I took vacation inside my home, going nowhere other than the garden. It was fun.
Mm-hmm. They used to call it staycation. It's the new normal for now.
A staycation is fun and it's a wonderful opportunity to get disconnected from the computer all day.
Yeah, it's a miracle nowadays.
It's a miracle, yeah. I used to have my 24 hours without electronics. Now, forget about it. Everything is Zoom meeting, Zoom meeting, Zoom meeting. Even for fun, it's Zoom meeting.
Yeah.
Also, the birthday celebration. It was my birthday at the beginning of August. Thank you for those who say happy birthday.
Happy birthday again.
And we had a lot of fun. A lot of fun doing Zoom meetings, Zoom celebrations for the birthday and eating wonderful food. We also have the summer-like weather in California. I love it. We can go for a walk in the morning, in the evening. It's so nice.
Until?
Oh, yeah, thank you. Until the last 2 days. We have this wave of heat. Horrible. It has been horrible. Well, let me tell you. No, I will take back that about horrible. My shaman teacher used to tell me that complaining about the weather is kind of being pampered, yeah? So no, I shouldn't complain about the weather. I don't want to complain about the weather. It's doing what it's doing. It's doing what we are doing with the earth. So a lot of heat. Of course, fires. We are in the Silicon Valley near to the zone of fires. Sadly, many people are being evacuated. As we speak, and our very little problem in comparison with being evacuated for us is we were not able to open even the windows or the doors because we have a smoke.
Mm-hmm. The cats were more upset than we were,
and the power.
Yeah, rolling blackouts.
Yes, so not able to use that much electricity during the day. Accordingly to my husband, lovely, I need to wash my clothes after 10 p.m.
That's right.
Yeah. So still patience. My patience is really being tested by this situation of a stay home. Well, please, before we dive into the topic really, go and sign up, if you haven't, sign up for the challenge to work on your anxiety, to manage your anxiety. It has been really successful especially in Spanish, but we have it for you in English. If you are only English speaking, go to emotionsinharmony.org/challenge and you will find 7 days of wonderful information. You get an email every day to work for 7 days on your anxiety. And in Spanish, you do /reto, and it's in Spanish too. People is loving it. People say that it's very practical, that they are getting a lot of out of it, because it's also, I suggest some videos and audios, etc., and meditations and everything. So it's a very good piece of work. You may enjoy it. Today, we are talking about how you can foster your happiness by doing very smart actions in your home.
And you have a good start.
Yes. So we are going to talk about inadequate lighting while working from home, in addition to the bad ergonomic, probably, system that you and I have in our home. We don't have the correct desk, or we don't have the correct chair, or we don't have the correct space, or we don't have the appropriate system for our body to be productive all day. Because we didn't, because we're supposed to go to our job and do there, yeah, whatever we need to do. Now we are at home. So there is a lot of learning in the ergonomic area. Today, my concern is that if you don't have adequate lighting, my concern is that in months from now or in the next year, we are going to be talking about depression, something that comes with bad lighting, any kind of mental illness that comes with. We are already dealing with a social isolation. We are already dealing with probably economic problems. We are already dealing with your health. Probably if you got the coronavirus, or your family member, or somebody you care about, or the death of a loved one because of coronavirus. And this small, nobody is really talking about lighting, because it's the least of our problems. But in a year from now, or in 2 years from now, we are going to regret it. So this is why I want to talk today about it. Inadequate lighting is associated, accordingly to research, with depression. And falls when older adults are elderly, don't have adequate lighting, they have more tendency to fall.
Yeah, more prone to accidents.
Yeah.
Especially falling.
Especially falling, yeah. And it's a circle. They don't have good lighting because they feel depressed, and they feel depressed because they don't have good lighting. It is a circle. So in a research setting, they discovered that people with depression tend to have inadequate lighting, and vice versa. People who have inadequate lighting, they have a hard time being happy. So listen to this. If you have good lighting, very good lighting, perfect lighting, and you have periods of you go somewhere in your home where there is not adequate lighting, or it's dark, and you are just going between the dark and good lighting, your mood tends to be stable. But if you have bad lighting and then you go to a place that is dark and try to go back and forth, you will have these mood swings. You will be irritable. You will be not in your behaving at your best. And you will never consider that it's because of the lighting. Of course, yeah. We are going to talk about the working memory. So far, we are talking about depression, and I am concerned about children getting depressed, and I'm concerned about adults in the family getting depressed. But also, we are going to be working from home, and we need to be productive. Children need to be productive, yeah? Working in their computers, in their iPads, the ones who have computers and iPads, because a good percentage in the world don't have computers or iPads, or phones, or internet, or anything to start the school. But if you are being connected to your device and you need to be productive, you are using your working memory. If you are doing a task, an intellectual task, you are using your working memory. The working memory is this small amount of information that is accessible for you, that is immediately accessible. And that working memory facilitates the planning, the comprehension, the reasoning, and the problem solving. This is when you go to the neuroscientists or the psychologists and they tell you a list of sentences or a list of colors or a list of numbers or something. They tell you, I'm going to tell you these numbers. And then they distract you. And then after a minute or so, they ask you, what numbers did I tell you? That is the working memory. Yeah. Working memory is this piece of information that is kind of, how do you say in the computer world, my dear? This piece of information that is just there for me sitting where I need it. Cookies.
Oh, cookies. Yeah, hidden in there. Yeah.
Yeah. This piece of information that is there for you. And that piece of information is processed in the prefrontal cortex. And the light gets directly to the prefrontal cortex. So this is why, hello, we want good light for you. Because we want you to be happy and productive when you want to be productive. So there is also something called the seasonal affective disorder. And we may just open another episode just for that. Because it's a topic in itself. But basically what I'm going to tell you today about the seasonal affective disorder is that people who live in a winter-like weather or is more exposed to winter-like, like people who live in the snow or in areas where it tend to be long days.
Dark and gray.
Yeah. They tend to be prone to depression too. So it's harder to get motivated. And you are thinking maybe right now, maybe, what happened with my teenager that wants to be in the dark all day, Carmen? And I say, get your teenager out of there. It's very healthy that we open the curtains, that we get the sunlight, that we go for a walk. It's very healthy that we get exposed to sunlight, that we get our doses of vitamin D. So if your teenager is always in the dark, please make excuses or persuade him or her to be out and to enjoy outside too. We have something that is the circadian rhythm in our body. So this circadian rhythm is our brain telling us when to sleep, when to be active, when to eat, etc. The circadian rhythm is part of the biological clock. The biological clock is the entire body moving around. And the circadian rhythm is managing, is helping us with these sleep-awake cycles, helping us with all of this when we want to go and open the fridge and just eat whatever is in the fridge. To tell you about the circadian rhythm, I am going to tell you that when I was a child, I didn't have electricity until age 11. I grew up without electricity. And it was fun. It was really fun because I could go to sleep at the same time as the chickens.
Everyone's goal.
Yes. I remember it was getting dark and the chickens were getting into their place and getting to sleep. And my mom was like, yes, you know, it's time.
It's great.
Yeah. So I had the life of a chicken, which is very healthy. And I wake up happier and healthier during the day. So we already talked about the prefrontal cortex. We are talking about that this circadian rhythm is in our thalamus and it works as a regulator for light and mood changes, also mood changes. So this is why light is extremely important. Don't worry, we have some solutions for you here that we put together. You may already, so far we are talking here, you may already came probably with some solutions. But this is what we came here for you. Look for natural light places when you are working. Like be ready to be working near to a window. Open the curtain, please. I know, my husband and I always keep fighting because he wants the curtain closed.
Only when it's hot to keep it cool if you're not in the room.
Yes, so we save electricity. Yeah.
And save the environment.
Yeah.
Using less.
Yeah, but I also want to save my brain and I want the curtains open.
You can also work outside sometimes.
Yes. When we can, we go and work outside. So it's possible. Whenever possible, please go and work in your garden outside. Bring your computer outside and enjoy from there. And plus, you don't need a natural Zoom background. You can have your own garden if your garden is good. Yeah.
The best kind of special effects.
Yeah, this is the best special effects and the beards and everything that is going on outside or whatever you have as outside in your home. Consider using the smart lights in general in your home. If you can afford them, to put these lights that you can control with your app. My husband has a long journey with these lights, yeah.
Well, some of them, yeah, some were okay. And then one set didn't work at all, up to 3 returns. And we have a new one that finally seems to be working. So be careful which ones you buy, I think, is the part of it.
Yes.
They can drive you crazy. We're talking about mental health. They can drive you crazy too.
So you compromise your mental health.
Yeah, you can.
By choosing. Will you care to share what is the brand that we are finally using properly?
We could put it in the notes.
You can put it in the notes. Because I can see the pain that my husband went through. To choose.
Yeah, it wasn't big suffering. It was just annoying pain.
Thank you, my dear. You are so nice. Always caring for us in the house. So he was taking care that when we move immediately into shelter in place, he was taking care that I have the perfect lights for my video making.
Took a while. We kind of got there.
We kind of got there. So we are going to share in the notes the brand that finally seems to be good ones for us. And of course, you can share also in the social media that we are what lights are working for you. And consider the specific lights for the computer, for devices. These small lights that you can put in front of your computer when you are doing the Zoom. Or the Ring. I got as a birthday present the Ring and it has been fabulous. I love it. I didn't know. But the Ring is similar to the light therapy box that we are going to talk about. But it's similar in the sense that the light to be considered as a therapy light needs to be between 2,800...
Lumens,
thank you. To 10,000. A Ring or the smart lights are usually a 5,000 or something like that. So it can work. And also, consider using a light therapy box for 15 to 60 minutes a day. Do they work, the light therapy box, you may ask? Yes, it exposes you to the light. And you know, when we are working, if you have depression, it may lower your depression, the light therapy box. When you are not depressed, when you are happy and okay, it just gives you more vitality. So it's still a good thing. 15 to 60 minutes a day, you can have one of these light boxes. And before, it used to be a whole huge thing that you go to therapy and they put the lights for you. And that was the way to treat depression. Now, Amazon has some light boxes that you can buy for cheaper.
They're pretty cheap, actually, yeah. I thought they'd be fancy. They're, you know, $30, $50.
Mm-hmm. $50 the most. So some of them, my husband and I, we had fun actually last Sunday doing some research. We didn't use any of them.
No.
But we found the ones that have better reviews or whatever. And we are going to put for you the links in the notes so you can go and take a look. We want you to be healthy and happier.
Absolutely.
If that helps, do whatever you need to do to help yourself and especially to help your children. Something that I may give you a word of caution with the therapy light therapy box or any light is that when somebody has bipolar disorders or is in this maniac episode or ADHD, when somebody is active, too active for their own good, you don't want to put them in that therapy light box that much.
Yeah. Oh, good point.
Yeah, because it might exacerbate something that we don't want. So only when you are at your normal or when you are lower than your normal, that will be good. So it's a word of caution. So I have a couple questions for you before we finish. Remember, we are doing our journaling. We are going deeper. Yeah, after these episodes. So these are the three questions that I have for you. Do I pay attention to my body's needs? Do I pay attention to my body's needs? Do I document myself in the appropriate sources? When you research for these lights or when you research for something about your mental health, please find the correct sources. What small or big changes do I need to make around my home? Yeah, what small or big changes I need to make around my home. this is the last question. And probably pretty simple. You just go and change the bulbs, the lights, the lamps, open the windows, go and work outside, go more for a walk, etc. And voila, you are free from depression. Yeah.
Well, I hope it helps.
Yeah, it helps. And if you have a bigger, deeper depression than that, then you go to the doctor, go to psychotherapy, and do whatever you need to do. But this may be a very good preventive. In this country, in the United States, we are not for prevention. Yeah.
Very true.
Yes, we need to work harder in prevention. Salutogenesis is called in Spanish, which is the focus on salud, on health. Please stay with me and keep focus on health, because we are going to be healthy at the end of this coronavirus. We are going to be. We are going to endure all of this.
Absolutely.
Well, please subscribe to the newsletter if you haven't. Don't worry, I don't send that often, the newsletter. I'm going to get more disciplined and send it. Stay there, because one day I'm going to get more disciplined about the newsletter. In Spanish, I am more disciplined though. Subscribe to the newsletter and share the content. You can subscribe in English or in Spanish. Yeah, one or another or both if you want. And share our content. Please share, because we want to eliminate depression in the world. Please share. And something, maybe if it's lighting the problem, we solve it. Yeah, something simple to prevent what is going to be a burden after all of this crisis that we are living. Thank you. This was Carmen Roman.
And Vince Gabrielson.
And we are really happy working for you here. Bye for now.
We have reached the end of another episode of the podcast Emotions in Harmony. See you the next week. Visit www.emotionsinharmony.org, where you can subscribe, find the notes, and be in direct contact with me. Thanks for listening.